This is the story of how two cousins from Texas changed the world of work forever. It's the tale of a small company that succeeded through marvelous ingenuity, a little bit of luck, and a whole heck of a lot of hard work. It's a uniquely American story about rising above the rest, about delivering more for less, and above all, about exceeding expectations. Meet Charles Nathan Williamson and Emmett Eugene Dickie. These Texas cousins started out in the vehicle and harness business and later sold hats. But they were really using their heads when in 1918 they purchased a small apparel firm called U.S. Overall. 4 years later, they renamed the business after themselves. And the Williamson-Dickie Manufacturing Company was born. Their very first product, all cotton button fly overalls, was a sign of things to come. They were simple and durable, and before long, they were flying off the shelves. As sales rose, new products came online, and the Dickies brand quickly became known for comfort, toughness, and value. By the end of the 1920s, sales had reached $500,000. Not even the Great Depression could stop Williamson-Dickie. The founders of the company refused to take salaries. While most businesses were laying people off, Williamson-Dickie added 250 employees to the payroll. With money tight in American households, Dickie's major selling points, durability and value, were more attractive than ever. From 1930 to 1939, sales doubled as workers wearing Dickies helped the nation get back on its feet. During World War II, Dickies became the choice of the U.S. government as Williamson-Dickie mobilized its operations and produced more than 9 million uniforms for America's armed forces. By the end of the conflict, the company had 2,000 employees and manufacturing facilities that spanned the continent. Dickies was well on its way to becoming a nationwide brand. When returning servicemen went back to work, Dickies provided them with a uniform for peacetime, the matched khaki set, which was wildly popular with workers of all kinds. Hollywood noticed too. Whenever the script called for a typical working man, the wardrobe department turned to who else? Dickies. Other companies might have rested on their laurels, not Dickies. During this era, the company introduced a number of innovations, including the easy alter waistband, crease-resistant fabrics, and brass zippers. The most significant breakthrough was a patent for the permanent press process, an idea Charles Donovan Williamson got while watching his wife give herself a home perm. With a well-established confidence in basic work apparel, it was a natural step for Dickies to develop comfortable, durable casual wear. By 1956, the company was selling apparel to 6 million people in all 48 states, and teen idol Pat Boone was singing the praises of Dickies. Now the whole world came calling, and Dickies expanded quickly to overseas markets like Europe, Asia, and the Middle East. As the 1960s unfolded, America's tastes were changing, and Dickies experimented with expanded casual wear and fashion lines for men. Dickies advertising from the period reflected the changing times, although this TV commercial was definitely old school.
They're wearing Dickies work clothes. Dickies are shape set, fortified with Fortrel. If Dickies can make the Three Stooges look good, imagine how great you'll look.
In the 1970s, Dickies apparel reflected the shifting attitudes. Within 10 years, Dickies advertising had migrated from Mo, Larry, and Curly to this.
Hey, they're not bad. Huh? Very nice.
Oh, they're wild.
Oh, they're really groovy.
Dickies designers became much bolder, offering unusual products in wild colors that matched America's more open, freewheeling lifestyles. Some of these new ideas worked, and some, well, Yet through this turbulent period, Williamson-Dickie never retreated from its commitment to deliver comfort and functionality to longtime workwear customers. Those core values made Dickies the dominant name in the workwear market by the late 1970s. As America's cultural influence grew throughout the world, awareness of Dickies grew too. During the 1980s and 90s, the global community couldn't get enough of American brands. Dickies stood for something real, and musicians, teen skateboarders, and 20-somethings in cities everywhere adopted the brand as an anti-fashion statement. Consequently, Dickies didn't have to work very hard for product placement, as stylists and costume designers recognized the inherent authenticity of the brand. Even in the office, America was loosening its collar and going back to basics. Dickies leaned on its vast expertise in basic apparel to develop clothes that people could wear to work and after hours. At the same time, Dickies took on the toughest customers of all, children. Dickies school uniforms delivered the same advantages as its workwear. And with public schools across the nation adopting uniform programs, Dickies began to reach a new generation of consumers. Today, Williamson-Dickie is still family-owned and managed, with headquarters in the same Fort Worth, Texas building that served as its first factory. By staying true to its founding principles and never straying far from its workwear roots, Dickies has become a global apparel pioneer, operating state-of-the-art manufacturing facilities, creating products the right way through global manufacturing compliance, maintaining the highest standards through company-operated quality assurance labs, and ensuring that those products get to market on time through new advanced technology distribution centers. Dickies continues its relationship with consumers through many powerful marketing channels, including image advertising in magazines and on television, promotions and sponsorships from professional bull riding to NASCAR racing, and an imposing presence on the retail floor. Williamson-Dickie has come a long way from a tiny firm selling overalls to farmers, and the company's founders wouldn't recognize many aspects of the modern 21st century enterprise. But they'd sure recognize the guiding principles of the business, which are as alive today as they were when the Williamson-Dickie Manufacturing Company was born. Wherever people appreciate a great product at a great price, wherever the core values of honesty and integrity are upheld, wherever there's hard work to be done, you'll find Dickies still exceeding expectations.